You're watching for Second News. For more information about PSN, visit our website at www.persecondnews.com. Stay up to date with Per Second News. Journalism of courage.
I am going to the second part of my speech that is not likely to be nice. Today, the judiciary of Cross River State is passing through a most needless and indeed useless crisis of succession. I have stood on this bar for 42 years. 26 as a lawyer and the rest as a senior advocate. This is the first time in my professional life, the substantial part that I'm seeing the mess, my lords, that we are in today. I say needless and useless, because if we have simply done what is right, we will not be in this quagmire. Justice, fairness, correctness are without color. They are unisex. They are without tribe or coloration or ethnic coloration. Therefore, to ethnicize justice in any way, especially by us who claim to be lawyers, is to betray and belittle our calling as lawyers. Today, there is no leadership in the judiciary of Cross River State, as a result of which decisions cannot be taken and new cases cannot be assigned. This will negatively impact on the economy of lawyers. And if it continues for this long, my lords, I will not be surprised if we see lawyers beginning to ride okadas in this town because of what is happening in the judiciary today. We pray that it doesn't happen. Let us just for a moment ponder on the other implication of the young lawyers sitting on this side of the hall who are eligible to apply for senior advocates of Nigeria, or even judges. That is the implication. For just failing to do what the Constitution says and what is obviously right. A judiciary cannot today have a chief judge who spent all her life in Calabar, whose mother is Efik, or Kwo, sorry, and her working life with the government of Cross River State, married to a prominent Efik, though Cross River by marriage. My own wife is from Anambra State, so you are giving me notice that we are not here. Obi Anibo was Solicitor General. I was in practice in this town when Anibo was Solicitor General. And Atakora Amu, a Ghanaian, was Director of Civil Litigation. I was in this town practicing as a lawyer. It states that we all had one of the earliest contacts with Western civilization, with an urban and global view of issues, retreating into an ethnic cocoon. This is certainly not what we want to look like or be remembered for. Definitely not a state that has produced two chief justices of the Federation. In the presence of Justice Daniel Alexander and our own homegrown Justice Walter Samuel and Kanu Onoghen, a state that has Kanu Agabiyese, a state that had Dr. Matthew Tawombu, Justice Edel Kufre, Margaret Ekpo, Dana Chibom, and many more. The state where Justice Wallace R.T. McCauley a Sierra Leonean who claimed on those states as a state of origin, was Attorney General of the state immediately after Justice Etowah Arifo, my colleague. Justice E.T. Dobeba was perhaps the first, and yet we claim to be promoting tourism. I do not pray that this should be Governor Ben Ayade's legacy. He is a lawyer, he is my colleague, we were colleagues in the Senate. I pray that he leaves the right legacy. And my Lord, any of you who has access to him, please tell him that the philosophers say never chase a lie, because it will sooner than later run out of breath. The correct things should be done always. The right thing should be done so that we can move on. Power is transient, and it is only useful if used for the common good and to promote the Constitution, our laws, justice, and equity. We must respect the sanctity of marriage and protect the family, which is the foundation of society. And we Roman Catholics believe the family is the first church. Let us do right, even if the heavens fall. I plead with you, my lords, not to lend yourselves to politicians, including me. In the legal profession, in the judiciary that I have known all my life, if you want zoning, come and join us in politics. And even in politics, zoning is going out of fashion. The risk remains lying before us should remind us of our own mortality. As one student in the famous St. Thomas's Teachers Training College, Abuja, creatively said in an essay about the death of a relation, and I quote him, "What was now once vertical is now horizontal," end of quote. I am standing vertically, Oriri is lying horizontally. But that horizontal position is our eternal destiny. It is the destiny of mankind, the destiny of anything that has life, him or her, or it. I conclude with Ecclesiastes, and I take this from chapter 2, verse 11. I quote, "Yet, when I surveyed all that my hands had done, and what I had toiled to achieve, everything was meaningless. A chasing after the wind, nothing was gained under the sun." End of quote. We must find a purpose in our lives. All good men and women must take responsibility to create legacies that will take the next generation to a level we could only imagine. That is by Jim Rohn. As we bid our brother and colleague Oriri Ekombe Oriri farewell, we should ponder on our own lives and indeed our debts and do the right thing always. Thank you, my lords, for this opportunity. May God bless us all.